bring it back. From the Groovy Maze Production Team Studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mixmaster G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs and macOS TechTalk in general. For those of you who are unfamiliar with me, very quickly, I am a 55-year-old dude from the Netherlands. I had my first DJ residency at the age of 15, which means this is 40 years of DJ experience in the flesh. I am no longer an active DJ. However, I like to share the knowledge I accumulated over the years with you guys out there. So I have this Ask Me Anything live stream each Tuesday, 7 o'clock p.m. Central European time. I am best known for as the developer of the DJ conversion utility, the tool that converts between various DJ software, maintaining your queues, loops, grids, etc. But I have made tons of other tools as well that can help DJs with collection management and conversion. Tonight, we have a very full plate. I have a very full agenda for you guys. So a lot of things I want to talk about. But first, let me say hi to the people in the chat already. AC Flow DJ, welcome to the chat, my friend. Good to see you. In general, if you've got questions, just throw them in the chat. And I will most likely finish the subject I'm working on, the topic I'm working on. And after that topic, I will go into your question and see if we can show you, demonstrate you how to resolve that particular issue you have. Because that is what this show is all about. If you like what I'm doing, then please don't forget to give this video the thumbs up. And if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, then you will get an update when I release new videos. I got a couple of new videos planned coming out soon. And for instance, yesterday I did a spontaneous live stream about how I deal with duplicates and tagging of tracks in my collection. And that might be interesting to some folks. So if you want to know how I go about that, please go back to or watch that video on demand in the YouTube channel, how I deal with duplicates and my tags. What are we going to talk today about today? I got three topics that are prepared. First of all, I'm going to show you what the new features are of the DJ conversion utility 5.15, which was just released last week. After that, I will answer some questions or actually demonstrate some questions that people had using the Denon conversion utility. And last, and that might be the most interesting part for everybody, I will dive into the most common issues that DJs have with Rekordbox and how you can fix them. So that will be a Rekordbox fix tutorial. It will be broad. I had slides. I have prepared slides for it. Make sure that everything is in good order. So I hope to see you there. But first of all, that very new... Do you plan on any videos with Traktor? Sure, what do you need? Because I am a Traktor user myself. Traktor is my base DJ software. So if you've got questions about Traktor, you can ask about it and I'm happy to answer that. Because Traktor is like my backyard. It is where I do my stuff. So I'm always happy to demonstrate stuff with Traktor. The new DJ conversion utility 5.15. What is new about that particular version is that this time around, it's not working. Hold on. Make sure that, oh, it's not working. Why not? I cannot go between my cams anymore. Double check if that is indeed not working. Now it's working. All right. It used to work. DJ conversion utility 5.15. What is new about it is that I completely rewrote all the all the parts that deal going from a Rekordbox XML to other DJ software. So for instance, if you are on Rekordbox and you want to go to Traktor, Serato, Ogrim's DJ, Virtual DJ, then you always have to create that Rekordbox XML. And you can create that fairly easy by just being in a Rekordbox and saying export collection in XML format. And then if you name it Rekordbox, then the DJ Converse utility will automatically find it. Now, the first thing that you will notice if you are using the new DJ Converse utility is that it is much, much, much faster in producing the overview of the playlists that you can convert from. I was thinking about showing you that, but I have to have a certain file for that. So let me grab that file first. Hold on, it is a little bit going back and forward today. I thought I had everything prepared correctly, but hey, sometimes you miss something, right? So I have this very big Rekordbox collection from a user of the DJ Converse utility. L, if you're watching, salute to you, my friend. And thanks for giving me that very big file. You can see it right here. And to give you an indication, that file is... I don't need to open, sorry. I wanted to get the information on it. That file is 82 megabyte big. And in the past, if we were using the DJ Converse utility, and actually I needed to help L with certain things, and when we're using the DJ Converse utility, it took like 20 minutes just to show the playlist overview. And I thought, I can improve that. And I did, actually. So if I fire up the DJ Conversion utility right now, and then you can see what those almost 30 minutes processing time came down to with the new DJ Conversion utility in terms of speed. We have to wait for the DJ Conversion utility to start up. For this, Rekordbox XML. Then if I drop it right in like this, and let's just say I want to go to iTunes, but I will cut it off when it starts processing because I don't have else files at all. So that part you won't see. But I just wanted to show you how incredibly fast the new DJ Conversion utility is in creating the overview. Remember, this almost took 30 minutes before, and now you can practically wait for it, and there it is. You can also see why this is usually taking a long time, because this is a huge list, and I like DJs like L who make very good, very clean collection with playlists and subfolders, etc. But you can see that is a huge improvement. But I did improve something else, and that is something that a lot of you asked about, because as you know, the DJ Conversion utility is always a led up by playlist. You always click, I want to convert that playlist and that playlist or that combination of playlists. And if a track is not in that combination of playlists, it will not be converted. And I fixed that too. I fixed something about it that is most easy to just demonstrate and show you how that works. And I needed not the DJ Conversion utility. I wanted to go to Rekordbox first, because let me create a very simple example collection here, and then drop everything in it, analyze it, shouldn't take too long, let's go. Then let me create playlist and other playlist, and let's call them list one, and you guess it, list B. So list one and list B, and let's put three tracks in list A. Let's put three tracks in, and even like this, in list B. Now, mind you, not all my tracks are in those playlists. There are some playlists in the collection that are not in those playlists at all. Let me export the collection to XML, which you always need to do with the Rekordbox. And I will do, why not, a conversion to Serato, which means I better reset my Serato collection entirely. Serato collection has reset it now. Let's give this a try. Let me show you what this will do. Rekordbox I just created. Want to go to Serato. And right now, if I start up Serato, you will see that the entire Rekordbox collection is empty. Let me eat a terabyte, which eats up Serato tremendously. So no crates, nothing in my Serato collection. That is exactly what I want it to be. Now, again, remember, not all my tracks are in playlists, but I have the Rekordbox XML right there selected. Let's open it. What we are doing right now. Like, went wrong there. Let's try that again, shall we? DJ conversion utility, where are you? Hi. A little bit better. Here we are. From a Rekordbox XML to Serato, like this. And then I do Command A. Command A means that I select both playlists, right? Now, in the past, you would only have conversion of the tracks that are in those two playlists, but now something special will happen. Serato to open, there we are. No, you can see besides list one and list B, there is a third crate created, and that is orphan tracks from XML with the date and the time between it. Those are all the tracks that are in the XML but are not in any playlist in Rekordbox. And that can be very, very useful in case you just want to make sure I want to convert everything in my collection. Now you can do Command A, and that means that it will convert everything. The old method is still there too. So if I just delete all the crates again from my Serato collection, and I say to the DJ conversion utility, only create a list B, for instance. Let me start the DJ conversion utility here. So that is very powerful stuff, folks. And some DJs were asking for this functionality. By the way, the new XML to Rekordbox 6, X26, the component that converts an XML straight to Rekordbox 6 without you having to import the XML, also have the new XML import routines. So that works exactly the same, and you can do exactly the same thing with it. Fire that up like this. And now if I only select list B or A, just one of the lists, so not all of them, just one, or another selection, but as long as you don't select all the playlists in your Rekordbox collection, then you just get only the conversion of the tracks of that playlist. So you see right now only list B there, and the orphan, etc. is not there because you made a particular selection. So that works kind of as a new method, and I think that can be very powerful. The other thing that I had this week kind of interacts with this. I had some DJs yesterday who are using Denon Prime as their performance platform, and they are using Rekordbox as their preparation software. And they use my tools to go from Rekordbox to a Denon drive. Now, let me hook up my external drive, my Denon drive, if you like, because the issue they had was the same. If you use an external drive like this as your Denon performance drive, you usually go with DJ conversion utility first by starting the iTunes Rekordbox collection backup tool, CBT for short. And let me start up CBT. And what the collection backup tool does is it will copy tracks to the target drive that are not already on the target drive or which were updated since they were copied to the target drive. So basically it is what is called an incremental backup. Now the trick with CBT is also that it can automatically start the Denon conversion utility after it has completed the backup. However, if it automatically starts the Denon conversion utility after backup, it will only tell the Denon conversion utility to process the tracks that are in either a playlist or a crate and that were copied over if a track is not copied over because the latest version is already on the target drive, then it will not process that track. That also means that it will not process the playlists it might be in. And I will show you exactly how that works. First of all, we have this the Rekordbox collection we just had with those tracks in it. Now, if I say start backup and automatically start the Denon conversion utility after the backup, all things are on automatic. So just sit back and wait a moment. Dear Claudius, you're more than welcome, always here to help. Not sure who you are. I helped today because I helped a lot of DJs, but always welcome, my friend. Etito Morales, salute, and good to see you today in the chat as well. So everybody, welcome. Again, we have a very full show today. This is one of the things I want to show about that we do first. And after that, there is the main thing of the show, and that will be the most common issues people have with Rekordbox and how to fix those. Let me end tracks. Let's quit this. I have to wait just to make a base here. I just want to make a base so you can see exactly what the problem of those DJs was, and then you automatically understand. Or then I will show you how to fix that, because it's very simple, but you really need to wrap your head around this. Conversion is done. If we look into the Denon conversion utility folder, we have to convert them. We have list A, list B, and there we have the playlist that are not in any playlist at all, as you can see. So a little bit of the same. Now, let me show you what happens if I go back to my Rekordbox collection. Quit. And I create a new playlist. And in that new playlist, I put tracks that are already on the target drive, that are already on the Prutz drive. So let's create a new playlist. And playlist, I know. And just put some tracks on it. All tracks are already in target drive, so I don't introduce any new track to the new playlist. I just take the three tracks that are already on the Prutz drive. Now, if I export this to Rekordbox XML, you always need to export again to XML when you change something in Rekordbox. That's the first very important step in this. If you forget that, then it will not fly at all, because then your base of operandi is wrong. So if I start the collection backup tool right now, and it will pick up that Rekordbox XML from the documents folder that I just exported, and we go to the Prutz drive, so that is all set correctly, then basically CBT will tell me, I can already predict that nothing was copied, and do I want to start DeCU? And yes, I can start DeCU. I can say, all right, start DeCU. And then the Denon conversion utility will pick up the Rekordbox XML that collection backup tool placed on the external drive. So not the XML in my source drive, not the XML that I did export, because that XML in the documents folder has the file paths pointing to tracks on my internal drive, and I want them to point to external drive, and that's one of the things the collection backup tool does. So it selects the XML on the Prutz drive, and then I can go around. So if I just say start conversion, then you can see that disabled, that I can convert just fine by just saying, all right, I only want to have that particular playlist. And of course, I was alerted now by the DJ conversion utility that this would go wrong, that nothing was copied. So what should I do? Now, there is also the instance where you have some extra tracks added. So let's go back to my Rekordbox again. And there we have the new playlist, and let's create an external tracks like this. Take some test tracks here. And now the problem is that it will not alert me. will not tell to me that nothing was copied, because it will copy something, it will copy those new tracks. That again, let's start up the collection backup tool. Which will copy those tracks from the external to the PUTS drive. Right. Then it will start up automatically the DEN and conversion utility, but it will only process those two tracks that were copied over. All the other tracks and the playlist they are in are not processed. So that new playlist that I created is still not created because those tracks were not copied over. And let's analyze the tracks. This with this. Always have to wait for the DEN conversion utility to see that engine prime indeed has been quitted and has been closed, because the last part it needs to be closed is very important, because otherwise things will conflict. The DEN conversion utility will start to convert while engine is still busy. Now, if I go to the converted playlist, you can see list one, list B, and the extra tracks are there. But that new playlist is not there. And to make sure that that new playlist is there, simply fire up the DEN conversion utility. It will automatically select the Rekordbox XML that is placed on the PRUTS drive. And then you will see that you can select the new list and that we can convert it. So you can see, here is the PRUTS drive Rekordbox XML selected. That is the one we need. So in general, when in doubt, when you are not, and then I can say the new playlist, and let's just convert it. You will see this goes very quickly because there is no analysis required and stuff like that. So basically it will just fly through and then open Engine DJ and the new playlist will be there. You see, there it is, new playlist. So the takeaway from this, if things don't show up the way you expect them to be after CBT and the DEN conversion utility, then simply only run the DEN conversion utility. And I will, just to make sure that you see exactly what I mean, open the target drive, open this one, and there you see the Rekordbox XML. It will automatically select that if it is the last used file, if it has the latest modification date. However, if you want to erase, sure, you can just drag it in, just like you can drag this in, and you can see that that will switch. Then you are absolutely sure, and then you can select any playlists you want to recreate, and it will be recreated exactly to your liking. So this is what you need to do if the results in the DEN conversion utility are not exactly as you expect them to be. Right, I happened to have two DJs yesterday with exactly the same question about this. That's the reason why I did it on this live stream, just to make sure that everybody understands how this works. It's not that complicated, but you need to know the method behind it. For everybody who is just joining, we are going to the last prepared topic of tonight, and the last prepared topic will be the most common problems that people have with Rekordbox in general and how you can fix it. Now, mind you, this will be mostly for Macintosh, but not only for Macintosh. There are some fixes that work on Windows as well. So even if you are not on Mac OS, welcome to the stream. Let's go. I'm going to show you how you can fix some stuff in Rekordbox if they are not the way they expected. Rekordbox troubleshooting. What I will cover is, first of all, we are going to look at importing tracks and exporting tracks. Importing tracks means you are going to add tracks to your collection and you get that dreadful, the tracks vadiwa could not be added, see the log file in the documents folder, which doesn't tell you much. I'm going to tell you why you see that particular message. We are going to talk about Rekordbox not starting up at all, or just giving you a black screen when it starts up, or nothing happens when you start it up. I'll tell you how most likely you can fix that. Then we have another category of problems, that is Rekordbox freezes all of a sudden. So you are just playing with Rekordbox and all of a sudden it freezes up. I'm going to tell you what the most likely cause for that is. And finally, we will have a deep dive into controller issues. Now, mind you, I am not Pioneer DJ's support department. My good friend Pulse from the Pioneer DJ forum is for that. So he usually helps you with that kind of stuff. However, I know a lot of, about this stuff, and not everything I'm going to tell you will be communicated by Pioneer DJ, not because they are afraid to share that knowledge, but more that if you are abusing this knowledge, then the problems can grow even bigger. So keep that in mind. Now, before you start with what I'm going to show you, cold reboot your computer. And a cold reboot means that you really literally shut down your computer. So you go to your Apple and you say shut down, or you go to your Windows and you say shut down, wait until it's entirely off, wait 20 seconds, you always need to do that with electronics just to make sure that there is no spike, and then turn it up again. Because most likely your problem will go away after a reboot. Reboots fix so many issues, you will be amazed. And the second very important thing is, please have a backup of your startup drive. Make sure that you made a backup of your startup drive just before you are going to troubleshoot. Because, like I said, you can wreak havoc with these procedures. And if you want to be able to recover it, you need to have a backup. Now, mind you, one backup is not a backup. At least have three backups on external drives. Have those drives on rotation. Make sure that at least one of those backups is not in the same building as your computers are. For instance, my backup, one of my backups is always in the glove department of my car. But just make sure that it's not, at, because if that building burns down, then your backup burns with it. And then it doesn't matter if you've got a gazillion backups, if they are all in that same building, you don't have any backups anymore. So please, please, please keep that in mind. The first and most important thing for Rekordbox troubleshooting elbows. Welcome to the chat, or welcome to the stream, my friend. Good to see you. We know each other from the Digital DJ Tips streams. Nice to see you. On Mac OS, it is very important that you give Rekordbox all the required permissions. Now, this varies from Rekordbox version to Rekordbox version, but let me show you what I mean by that. And if this would work, that would be really fine, but I don't know why my little thingy is fighting me. Jan Willem, goedenavond vriend. Good to see you. Now I have to find out how I can manually do this, because usually I use a shortcut to switch my cams, but somehow OBS refuses to respond to my cams. Really don't know why that is, but I need to find out, because it is not, no, it's not, all right, desktop and small, that would be the one. Yeah, that's the one indeed. Weird, that's not back and forth. We can manage. All right. Let me go to my M1 computer and let me show you what that means. Give Rekordbox all the required privileges. And let's go. Starting TeamViewer on my other screen, and then I drag it right here. Here we are. Now, what I'm about to show you might look different on various versions of Mac OS. But trust me, it is so important. You go to your system preferences. There you go to security and privacy. That's this one. Under security and privacy, you go to accessibility. You unlock it by clicking the little lock, the left lower hand of the screen. And then make sure that Rekordbox is in accessibility. You can see it right there, and that the little checkbox in front of it is indeed enabled. The other very important one is full disk access, right there. If Rekordbox is not there, then you will get all kinds of troubles when you try to put something in it. So that is the other very, very, very important one. accessibility and full disk access. And by the way, that is not only for Rekordbox, that also goes for all other DJ software, and it goes for my apps. Make sure they are both in full disk access and accessibility. That is the most important thing to first know, because it is, trust me, the number one reason why things go wrong. Then the second one, if you import tracks, there are two things that are important to keep in mind. First of all, Rekordbox has some what I call illegal characters. Characters, if they are in the file path of track, it will make that the track will no longer import. Remember, file path is not just the track name. File path might also be the folder that the track is in, or one of the parent folders of the folder structure. So not only the file name, but, and I will show you in a moment what that means, but the most likely illegal character is the backslash. If there is a backslash in a file name or in the file path, the track will simply not import. The same with file paths that are over 256 characters long. And again, that is not just the file name, it is the entire file path, so including all the folders and subs. If that grows beyond 256 characters, then Rekordbox refuses to import those tracks. Let me show you how that works, because seeing is believing, right? And then I have to manually switch again. We are still on the Monterey Mac Mini, and let's fire up my Rekordbox there. Yep, if Rekordbox doesn't accept drag and drop, that means that you didn't add it to your full disk access. So add it to your full disk access in the system preferences and you'll be fine. You will see in a moment that I'm going to drag and drop this all the way down. So first of all, I have a folder here, more test tracks. Now let me put a backslash just at the front of this particular track. Let me take that one out for the moment. And the moment I put this folder right in, there we have this famous thing. And what is the problem here? The problem here is that you can see that it is missing. The Nirvana track is missing because it has a backslash in it. If I take that backslash away, I can edit and it will be added, as you can see. Now, to show you that this doesn't only affect file names, but also file paths, so also folders, I put a backslash in front of this folder, and it will not import anything because, like I said, it is a backslash in the file path, not just the file name. That is throwing this off. In the past, you had Axel and Ingrosso, and they liked to write their name like this. Axel, sorry if I butcher it, and in it was like this in file tags, and that means that it was like that for a lot of file names as well. And if you try to drag and drop that Axel and Ingrosso track in, and it didn't work just because there was a backslash in it. Now, there might be other legal characters. I know there are others, but I didn't find them again. So if I drag and drop it now, you'll see that it will work. By the way, Elbow Bokes, I still don't know how to butcher your name. This file path issue, what I just explained, is the same on Windows. If there is a backslash in your file path somewhere, then you will have this issue and it will not work with drag and drop, period. So that is that. That is the backslash in the file name. Now, I have here a folder and it has a very long name. As you can see, a very long folder name that is hard to see. And then I did duplicate it a little bit. Now, if I put a track in there and I try to, let's make sure that this one is just test tracks one or test tracks one. Don't get confused about it. Now, everything in my computer park is fighting me. I don't know what one of those days, right? Right, more test tracks like this. All right. Now, if I drag and drop it right here, I will get that message again. Why is that? Because the file name is too long. Hey, that up right now. Maybe I should make it a little bit longer. Not complaining this time around. No idea why, but let me longer too. Let me. Parentheses are allowed, if I'm not mistaken, Taito, but I can double check that in a moment. Hold on. There you go. This is because the file path was becoming too long, so now it doesn't work anymore. So once it hits 256, then you see that it doesn't work anymore. Most things that you can expect are allowed, but some are not. Again, I made that a very long file name on purpose, so that went wrong. Test tracks. And then I don't want to know if we put parentheses on it. Now I need to know again, parentheses are dot those this or this or this. You drag it in. Problem, but I remember there is more. There used to be the semicolon with the comma at the bottom, but right now that isn't anymore. I can put that one in front of it and that will work, and that was used to be an illegal character in the past as well. But again, I don't know from the top of the head all the Rekordbox illegal characters, but if you got the famous cannot add those tracks warning, either track length of illegal characters or illegal characters in the file path. And especially the last one is hard to find because they might not be in the track name, but they might be, or in the audio file name, they might be the container folder names. So something to keep in mind. Back to the slides. Then we've got the export to CDG USB. And that needs to have a little bit of explanation, because I see often DJs in on Reddit or on forums asking questions, and they say, all right, my tracks are on a USB and I cannot use them in Rekordbox. Tracks on USB say nothing, because tracks on USB can also mean from, all right, I have all my audio files that are part of my Rekordbox collection on a USB. And that is actually what I always suggest, what I always advise people to do. Just put your tracks on a separate volume, and that can be an external USB. How that USB is formatted doesn't matter, as long as the OS can read it. So if you are on Windows and that external USB is NTFS formatted, Rekordbox can work fine with it for its collection. However, if you mean a Rekordbox prepared CDJ USB, so a CD USB that you can put inside a CDJ and play tracks off, then it's a different story. That thing needs to be formatted either FAT or it needs to be formatted macOS extended. Anything else will not fly. If you format that drive XFAT, then Pioneer will tell you, or Rekordbox will tell you, I cannot work from that drive because it's FAT. It still can have tracks on it, and Rekordbox can still read those tracks for its collection, but it cannot prepare that USB for use on a CDJ. So you cannot use it with the sync manager, for instance, because it has been wrongfully formatted. Now, for those of you who are wondering, what does that mean? Single partition, MBR, I don't know. That simply means that if you are using an external drive with Rekordbox, pull my screen up again. One. And let me show that on macOS, because hey, easier on that. Applications, utilities, disk utility right there. Better, I can show it better on my own system, main system. Hide TeamViewer here for this. Oh, might have to. If I go to disk utility. And it has already a drive. It has the Prutz drive, which is an FAT drive, because I just used that. You can see the format is XFAT with my Denon Prime little demonstration. And Denon Prime can work from both FAT and XFAT and nothing else. So if I go to there and I say Sync Manager and I say I want to synchronize to Prutz, it doesn't give it as a choice because it doesn't work with those kind of drives. If I say right here Prutz and I click it, then you get that famous you cannot use it because it's wrong formatted. Very important. Listen to that thing. But it can still hold the tracks for my collection. So right here we have the tracks. Let me empty this. Let me just empty it entirely. Let me empty this one. And it has tracks because I just copied them over to them. Tracks from here. Inside the collection. You'll see that works just fine. So that is the difference between using tracks in your collection, which will work just fine regardless of the format of your drive, and accessing a device because you want to export for performance mode on a CDJ player or another standalone thing from Pioneer. So that is a big difference. There's a difference between collection tracks and CDJ prepared tracks. Now let me show you the correct way to do this. Collection again. For a CDJ, if you don't have this view, and you see this view, with this view, I mean, you can see basically the device it is on and the partitions it has, then you are in the wrong setting. If you are in this setting, I only see Prutz. The problem with that is if I erase it, I don't have the choice how to erase it. I can only say XFAT or FAT, but I cannot see send the partitioning scheme, and that is just as important. So in order to make that available, you go to your Show All Devices view, right there. Then you click the top device, which is the IC box in my case. Click Erase, and then I can say I want to have a master boot record, and I want it to be an MS-DOS FAT, and that's it. And then I can erase it. And after that, you will see that Rekordbox is perfectly fine with using this untitled drive. Let me give it the correct name, so at least tell what they are for. If I want it, you can see that right now it is a FAT32 drive. And if we fire up Rekordbox, the Rekordbox collection is fairly empty. So let's give it some quick tracks there. Like this. Like that. And now I can access it. As you can see, it will not complain because it is correctly formatted. And if I go to the Sync Manager and say I want to go to Prutz and do all the playlists to Prutz, then I can just do that and it will be there. By the way, very important tip. If you are using the Sync Manager, as I just did, for syncing your tracks to a playlist, always check that those tracks are there. You can check it right here. And you can load the track from it. And then if it cut cues, you can see if it cut cues, if the grid is there, etc. So that is your check. If you don't have CDJs at home, but you need to be sure that your CDJ USB will work, this is your check. Go to devices and just load some tracks from it. And see if all the information is there. Okay, so that is about exporting tracks and why that is particularly important. Another minor thing is some of those USB thumb drives have a little tab that you can change and that will write protect it or unwrite protect it. Especially those SD cards have that at the side of it. Please make sure, double check that it is write enabled because otherwise it will not work. It is write protected. So that's another thingy, but most common thing that goes wrong with this is that the drive is not FAT or macOS extended formatted or not MBR, or if it has multiple partitions. stuff like that, single partition, MBR, FAT will always work, period. And make the distinction between a USB that holds the tracks for your collection versus a USB that you can put into a CDJ, for playing back. Another thing that is plaguing some DJs is Rekordbox is not starting up. No matter what you try, it is not starting up. It gives a black screen. It might give you an error that the Rekordbox agent could not be initialized, stuff like that. If that is the case, then you have a pretty serious problem on your hand, but it is fixable. Most of the time it is fixable because there are two kinds of Rekordbox preferences. One is regarding the settings of the app. The other is holding the collection data. Those are two separate preferences. So settings for the app versus collection data with the playlists and the tracks and the cues, etc. If Rekordbox is not starting up, then you have an issue with the preference, or you might have, let me be a little bit careful there, might have an issue with the preferences of the app, which means that most likely your collection is just fine. But for instance, if you go from one computer to another and one computer had a specific video card and the new computer has an entirely different video card, then sometimes those preferences can be messed up. And that means that they will no longer work. Famous black screens if you start the Rekordbox, stuff like that. How can you fix it? You have to go to the Library Application Support Pioneer folder. Now, keep that in mind. It's a long one. And let me show that to you, what that means. Layman's term, so this one. Now, that is the hidden library. The little tile in front of /library tells macOS, go to the hidden library. If you want to do that manually, if you press the Alt or the Option key on your keyboard and you go to the Go menu at the top of the Finder, so be in the Finder, go to the Go menu, and if you then press the Alt or Option key, you will see that this library appears. That is the library we need to be at. That is not, and again I repeat, not the library at the root of your hard drive. Not this library. Not. No, it is in the Finder. Press the Alt button, then the library right here. Then if you go to Application Support, there will be a Pioneer folder right here. In the Pioneer folder, you see a Rekordbox 6, a Rekordbox Agent, and a Rekordbox Cloud Agent. Easiest way to see if your problem is with any of those preferences is simply rename that Pioneer folder. Rename it to Pioneer Defect, like that. I don't care. Then fire up Rekordbox. That means that all your preferences are gone, but not your collection. Only your preferences are gone. So if I fire up Rekordbox, it will ask me, first of all, to unlock, and then it asks you for the email, for everything else. If you jump through all those hoops, then most likely your Rekordbox will start up again, if you are lucky. So that is resetting the Rekordbox preferences, the app preferences. If I take this away and I rename this back to Pioneer, that is why I don't remove it, I rename it, then I just got my Rekordbox back. Normal, and everybody is weer een happy camper again. So that is why I do it like that. I always rename, I only remove if I'm certain that the problem is there. So that is for the black screen, Rekordbox not starting up, etc., etc. problems. Let me get back to my slides again. Then we have the other one, and that is a more difficult one. That is Rekordbox freezes or crashes all of a sudden. So you are using Rekordbox, you are using the tracks, everything is fine. All of a sudden, it stops. It doesn't work anymore. Nothing responds. It freezes. If you have that particular issue, then the first thing you need to do is restart the computer with the reopen and disabled. So you always get the little dialog, reopen Windows after restart. Switch that off, because otherwise it might open Rekordbox again. You need to disable Cloud Sync on the my page. And let me show you what that means. Let me go back to my that if I have to do it manually. You have the shortcut for that, and I press the shortcut and it will switch back and forth, but now I have to do it manually. For the tricks I'm going to show you next, you need to have Cloud Sync disabled, because otherwise it will intervene with what you're trying to fix. Cloud Sync you find in Library Sync right there. It is switched off because I switched off the plan, but if your plan is on, your creative plan is on, this done, then I can come on. That is forever. Here we are. Then you can say in Library Sync, switch that off. You can see that it's off. And you need to switch that off. You need to make sure that Cloud Library Sync is off. Otherwise, it intervenes with what you're trying to do. Back to my slides. And then it is trial and error. And that is always the frustrating part. But most likely, your issue is with a particular track. And it's very simple. If you load that track, Rekordbox freezes. Or if you load that track, everything becomes very slow. That is an indication that that particular track is having your issue. The first thing you want to do is reanalyze that track. Just see if the issue goes away if you reanalyze that track, because the analysis data might be the problem here. So if I go back to my thingy, just click the track that slows everything down, right click it and say analyze track, analyze for BPM, for key and for phrase, and for focal. Just put everything on and then say, okay, analyze it. And that will make sure that at least the analysis file is not the problem. If the problem then persists, so you load that track, everything slows down again, or freezes, or whatever, or you get an error message, then you can try to reload the text. Right here, reload text. That might refresh the artwork of the track. So maybe the artwork is damaged inside the Rekordbox collection data. You reload the track, that is refreshed, and maybe then it works. If that doesn't fix it, then it is most certainly audio format or the audio file itself. Then the only thing you can do is just show it in the Finder, and you may want to re-encode it. So load it, for instance, in Audacity, then export it again from Audacity, edit again to your Rekordbox collection. But that is about what you can try. Those things you can try. Analyze the file. If the problem goes away, if not, reload the tags, problem goes away. By the way, if you analyze the file, make sure that you check all the boxes to analyze it. And if that doesn't work and you still get a problem if you load that particular track, then most likely what you need to do is re-encode that file and remove it from your collection. Because if you keep it in your collection, you might struggle if you incidentally load it again. So the moment you know for sure, all right, this track, if I load it, it frees my collection. I've tried all those things Mixmaster G said, it didn't fix it. Remove from collection, period. Or better, first show it in the Finder. There it is. Then remove it by command. Remove it and then say remove it from your collection. Then you know for sure that that track won't bother you again in the future. That is one thing. However, there might be another thing. The other thing, that is basically when you can reproduce the problem. If you cannot reproduce the problem, so you were playing from your laptop at a gig and everything worked just fine, and you try to load those tracks in the order you used to during the gig, and it doesn't freeze or it doesn't hang up or it doesn't give you any issues, then most likely the problem is with your OS or with your hardware. And that is something I cannot fix here for you, because that is something you need to do yourself. Now, another thing that you might want to play a little bit around with is with the databases, because Rekordbox keeps a certain amount of databases and the artwork, etc. files. Before you do that, always important, quit Rekordbox. So right now I am on Rekordbox is open on my computer, so I need to quit it. And then if I go to my library folder again, you see that library folder, keep the Alt button pressed. This. And then we are not going to the application support. That is for the application preferences. No, we are going to the Pioneer folder. That is straight into that local Pioneer folder. And there is a Rekordbox. Rekordbox current, by the way, is an old backup of mine. There's a Rekordbox folder there. And that is the place where both Rekordbox 5 and Rekordbox 6 maintain their backups and their collection data. Now, if you look at one file, MasterDB, right here, that is your main Rekordbox 6 collection. Now, if you look above it, you also see a master backup 2 and a master backup 3. Each time you quit Rekordbox, that backup file is created from the master database. Now, keep that in mind. Each time you quit Rekordbox, a new one is created. That also means that if you are in Rekordbox and you see that you have problems with Rekordbox, for instance, you deleted the playlist by accident, some tracks by accident, like I just deleted some tracks, remember? If I start Rekordbox 3 times, then all those backups will only contain the collection without that playlist and without that track, because basically the backup was refreshed. However, if I take this MasterDB and I throw it away, I rename this one into MasterDB, then you will see that, I think it was mod to claim the track that I removed. If I start the Rekordbox up right now, you'll see that all of a sudden that track has returned to my collection because I restored, there it is. Because I did reinstall the master database, and if I load it up, it's not analyzed anymore. Oh, it cannot be found because I did throw it in the trash, remember? But you get the picture. So that is the way you can always go back to a previous version of Rekordbox, just in case you have problems. That is also the thing where you can play around if you want to make sure that, hey, what's going on? I want to try another database, or my Rekordbox is not starting up, or you want to start entirely from scratch. You want to start with an empty Rekordbox collection, you can just say MasterDB alt, and if I start up Rekordbox right now, I will start with an empty Rekordbox. And that is why it's so important that you disable cloud sync before you do this kind of stuff. Let's start with an empty library, but this also gives you the possibility to go convert from your previous Rekordbox 5 again. Usually you cannot do that. Once it is converted, that's it. If you rename the master database, then you can all of a sudden convert from Rekordbox 5. So it gives you a lot of pointers to fix certain things. But again, before you start to do that, have backups, because this is very sensitive stuff. I also told you that sometimes the Rekordbox artwork or analysis data might be the problem. Those are kept in different folders. So if you want to work with that, then it's much easier to just rename the Rekordbox alt, and fire up Rekordbox, and then it will, hold on, Rato, want to do. Exit, I wanted to go to Rekordbox. That is my bad. We have to be a little bit patient here. Of course, and there we are. They can say convert or library, and then everything will be empty, including no analysis files, no other stuff. And this is your surest way to start with a clean slate. It will have all the default Pioneer demo tracks and stuff like that. So that is your ultimate. My Rekordbox doesn't work anymore. I need to start from scratch. You do that by renaming that Rekordbox version, and that Rekordbox version again. The Rekordbox folder again is you go to your library folder, you go to your Pioneer folder, and there you find that Rekordbox folder. And if I just rename this one back, then I have my old collection back. So always be careful with what you delete. Often renaming gives you just as much flexibility without definitely doing stuff empty line. So that is that. Then finally, back to my slides because those are my guidelines. By the way, if you are on Windows, you can do this too. What I just showed you with the Pioneer folder with master database. If you go on Windows to your percentage app data percentage folder, then you will find exactly that same structure and you can do exactly those same things. It will have exactly those same backups. Everything will look the same as I just showed you. So on Windows, you can do the same thing for the collection database as I just showed you on macOS. Then finally, if you have controller issues, audio is not coming out of your controller. Your controller is not responding. Your controller is not recognized. First thing you need to do is check if that controller is supported by the OS you are working on. This is important, folks, because lately with Big Sur and with Monterey on macOS and with Windows 10, a lot of controllers have not received updated drivers, which means they are obsolete. They won't work, period. Whatever you want to do, it won't work anymore. So you need to check that. The next thing you can always check is reseat those USB cables, or worst case, replace them. Reseating just means you take a USB cable, you pull it out of the controller, and you pull it in again, and you do exactly the same thing at the computer side of the cable, and you can even try a different USB port on your computer, see if that fixes it too. If you have issues with the controller, always eliminate any hubs in your chain. If you use a USB hub, eliminate it. If you are going from FireWire or from USB-C to USB-A through a hub, use a cable. Use a USB-C to USB-A cable instead of a hub. So if there is a hub in between chain, take the hub out and just try only the cables. That most certainly might fix the problem. And finally, if you are on Apple with an M1 processor, those are the Apple Silicon processors, then make sure that you follow the specific guidelines for installing drivers on an Apple M1. And I hear you think, hey, can Pioneer DJ not just fix this because it is a burden? You have to start up in emergency mode and then you have to disable this and that and terminal commands. And I'm afraid Apple or Pioneer DJ cannot do a thing about it. Apple decided that in order to keep you, the user, safe from harm, that they seal operating system. They seal it. And the only way to unseal it is go through that specific procedure. Basically, you allow Pioneer DJ or any other software to expand the system with certain extensions and stuff that is required to make it work. And Apple wants you to give specific permission for that and rather not make that very easy for you. So it is not like, do you want to click cookies and you click yes, I accept. No, they want to make it a little bit more difficult so you are aware, all right, what I'm doing is not a simple thing and I might introduce harmful apps that way. Pioneer DJ doesn't distribute harmful apps, so don't worry about that, but just that you know that that is how it works. Those, my friends, were the steps that I wanted to share with you guys about how to troubleshoot any problems with Rekordbox. Those are things that come from my experience and they might help you out with it, especially resetting the application data can often repair things that looks like they are non-repairable. And the good thing is then you still have your collection data. So if you have issues with your Rekordbox, just refer to this particular part of the AMA live stream and then you can try if you can fix it. That also means that I came to the end of this AMA live stream for this Tuesday. Unless you guys might have any specific questions, which I'm more than happy to answer if I can. So if you do have them, please drop them in the chat and I can see again what we can do about it. AD Flow, thank you. Yeah, I try to do my best. I'm not a graphic artists, so they don't, my slides are always very basic and very pragmatic, just the way I am, trying to just share the knowledge and try to make sure that at least you have some handles that you can try if you have problems with Rekordbox. And some of those things not only are for Rekordbox, but they are sometimes for other DJ software as well. It's just a matter of, hey, whatever you want. All right, folks, that means that I am going to sign up for today. Thank you all for watching. Again, if you like what I'm doing, don't forget to give this video the thumbs up and tell your DJ friends about the availability of this service if you like. And I hope to see you all next Tuesday in a live stream. In the meantime, I am preparing some new tutorials, so keep an eye on the YouTube channel. Just subscribe to the YouTube channel so you get an alert when those are released. And I hope to see you guys all next week. Thanks, Master.